Well, hello, everyone. Welcome to MadeFitTV.com. I'm your host, Jennifer DiDonato, and this is episode number 40. We're officially middle-aged, thanks to you. Thanks so much. If it weren't for you guys, we obviously wouldn't keep doing this. So thanks so much for watching. And today, first, I would just want to give a shout-out to someone who's doing an awesome thing. I like when people incorporate health and fitness into their life, of course. I want to recognize Coach Austin. He's from Maryland. He is a high school physical training teacher, and he contacted me. And he had a really cool website that he had made for his students, and he's got a lot of different interactive workouts on it. Check it out if you get a chance. It's pretty cool, because what teacher does this? But I also want to say hi to his students out there as well. They're pretty lucky to have someone like this. But check out this website, CoachAustin.tripod.com. There's no www, just http://coachaustin.tripod.com. So I want to say thanks and a shout out to you guys over there. Okay, so episode number 40, we're doing negative resistance training. This is one negative, that's a positive, in exercising. And what this incorporates today is kind of similar to what we did a few weeks ago with plyometrics. If you didn't, go ahead and check it out on madefittv.com. I explained the difference between concentric muscle movement, which is the contracting of the muscle, and eccentric, which is the lengthening, but also the contracting of a muscle. And today, negative resistance training is all-encompassing of the eccentric movement of the muscle, the lengthened stage. And the reason why it's really important to incorporate this into your training, whether you're a beginner or whether you've been doing it for a while, is because it's good to strengthen the muscle in different stages. You know, if you are contracting it on the way up, obviously you're getting that strength with that, but you also want to strengthen it on the lengthened stage because that prevents injury. And when you're training a muscle in different facets, it's going to be more prepared for different challenges that you place upon it, and it's also going to be less prone to injury, and that's the most important thing. So getting started, I'm going to show you three movements. First movement that we're going to do right now is going to be a concentration bicep curl. So you can go ahead and pull out, Chris. I'm going to see, let's see, what weight should I grab? Let's just grab a 10-pounder. With all these movements that we're doing today, whether you're a beginner, you know, usually if you're starting out, you want to grab weight where you're hitting muscle failure, which is when you can't do anymore, at about, at the most, 15 to 20 reps. If you have been doing this for a while, strength training, 8 to 12 reps. You want lower reps and higher weight. Well, with this, it's going to be a little bit tedious. We have a tempo that goes with this. I'm just going to have a seat. I'm going to do one arm at a time, concentration bicep curl with the negative resistance training. Go ahead and rest your elbow on your knee and just kind of slightly lean forward. Now the tempo here, I know you guys are probably used to just pumping it up just like this, but what I want you to focus on, we're going to have a tempo of 3, 1, 6. And what that means is we're going to count to 3 slowly on the up, hold for one count in the isometric stage when you're holding that, and then bring it down counting to 6. It may be a little tedious, but follow along with me, okay? So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Bring it back up. 1, 2, 3. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now, depending on the type of weight that you have, and if you really can't hold it for that long, just really, really try. It's a little bit harder for me to hold it for 6 counts because this weight is a little bit lighter than what I'm used to working with. So I'd probably, for me personally, work with about 12 or 15 pounds because I want to get 3 sets of 10 reps on each arm. So try that when you're doing your bicep curls because you're going to feel the next day, you're really going to feel that delayed onset muscle soreness, and that'll really start those little tears in the muscles. That's good because it kind of stitches back up when you recovery and repair and get your muscle to be stronger and the recovery. So I'm going to go ahead and stand back up because now I'm going to show you a second movement. This is going to be the dumbbell chest fly. I'm going to grab the other 10-pound weight over here. You can do this on the ground or you can do it on an elevated bench or a stability ball as well if you want to work your core. So I'm just going to take this off though so I don't mess with this. All right. So you're just going to go ahead and lay down. You're going to start with your palms facing each other. And I want your arms to be slightly bent. You're going to open up. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I'm sorry. Let's redo that. Okay, you're going to start with your arms, palms open. You're going to count 1, 2, 3 and hold at the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. You're really going to feel that when you're bringing it down. you're going to feel it right in your pecs because it's resisting, especially against gravity. You want to keep your back nice and straight. You don't want any space to be between your back and the bench. So tuck that belly button in, kind of press it to your spine. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and back up. Exhale on the exertion. This is a really killer movement, so I'd recommend starting out lighter weights because you don't want to strain your muscles, and you want to make sure that when you're going back that you don't hyperextend, you don't want to hyperextend your shoulder too far back because then it may be harder getting it back up. So start with the palms open, and then on the resistance, on the downward against gravity is when you're doing those six counts for that tempo. It's going to be really killer, and you're really going to feel it in the chest. Now, the final movement that we're going to do, and I'm going to go ahead and grab a little bit lighter weights because this one is really going to blow out the shoulders. I think I'll grab some 5-pounders just in case I'm a big wimp, you know what I mean? I don't want to embarrass myself in front of you guys. Okay, so this is going to be a front shoulder press. You're just going to bring your elbows up, nice 90-degree angle, have the forearms parallel to the ground. You're going to press it 1, 2, 3, and hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I'm going to show you from the side as well. See how I'm not overextending, hyperextending that past my shoulders. Nice and slow. And you're probably going to think, like, gosh, this is so slow. I'm not used to this. But I guarantee you the next day, and while you're doing it right now, even with these 5 pounds, I'm really starting to feel it right in the shoulders and in the forearms. Keep the abs nice and tight. 1, 2, 3, and hold. Especially with gravity working against it. Ah, it is not, well, it's fun, but it's not painless. You know what I'm saying? So try all these movements. Just remember that tempo 3, 1, and 6, or you can bump it down to 5 if you feel like you just can't take it, or lower the weight. But this type of movement is really good and just giving something a little bit different with those muscles and having them be more well-rounded. And you will definitely see a change if you incorporate this just even a couple days a week with different big muscle groups. You can do it with back, legs, you know, when you're doing squats, you can do it with triceps, anything. Just incorporate this in there. And like I said, if you're a beginner, start with the lighter weight and the higher reps, because I just want you to try to kind of ease on into it. I don't want any injuries, and I don't want you to be too sore the next day. So just incorporate this a couple days a week. Let me know how you like it on madefittv.com. Go to the Ask Jenny section. You can send me questions, comments, emails. Let me know how it's going. You know, some show suggestions as well, because I want to hear how you guys are liking these shows right now. And we're also on iTunes. Made Fit TV is the keyword. Also on YouTube, Made Fit TV. Subscribe through there. Most importantly, just subscribe through it on madefittv.com. Just put in your email address. It'll shoot an email right to you, because we post these every Wednesday morning. And we also got our Ustream going on live every Saturday at noon. So I just want to thank you guys so much. And you know what? Check out Coach Austin. See what some people out there are doing. They're incorporating health and fitness into their life and just taking it a step above and helping people around you and getting involved into what you care about. It's going to make their life so much better. So it's pretty awesome as well. And also we got Vidler. Hey, I'm on Twitter. Jenny DiDonato, twitter.com/JennyDiDonato. And also Facebook, I'm Jennifer DiDonato on there. And you know what, I just have to say about Facebook, I don't know, Chris, what do you think? I'm really not a fan of like how they're trying to make it look like Twitter. I don't know, I just can't really get into it right now. It was a couple days ago, I just logged on. I'm like, huh, this looks kind of different. You know, because you see like everyone's updated status, and I'm like, well, it's a little bit different. Yeah, definitely check it out. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. So thanks so much for tuning in for Made Fit TV, episode number 40. And I look forward to seeing you next week. Take care.